What's going on, everybody? Welcome back. Here we are at New York Comic Con. Day four, the last day. Aw, everybody's sad. I'm Ezekiel III. I'm sitting here with my boy Swiftor, who was just over there with the Lucha Underground.
Oh, yeah. Some beautiful ladies over there.
Oh, yeah.
Beautiful ladies. And some beautiful men.
Yeah, let's not.
Of course.
There's some hunks of man meat there.
That is completely true.
And the guy who just decided to interject with no introduction is my
boy. Because I need no introduction, Zeke.
You all know who he is, I'm sure. Asterios Cook.
Good enough. Asterios. Right? If you can call yourself Swiftor, I can just call myself Asterios.
Asterios Absolutely. And we're here for a very cool segment that I really wanted. I looked at the schedule today and went, I want that. That sounds awesome.
Yep.
We're going to talk about some bad toys.
Yes.
Go ahead.
Look, I don't consider them bad toys, guys.
Right.
I'm a representative of a company called Toys for Cheap. And we sell toys that I think are actually really fantastic. Here's our catalog. You can get it at Amazon.com if you search for Toys for Cheap. That's number four. Hi, got one guy taking a picture of me. And I'm going to show you guys some of my toys, and we'll see what you guys think.
That
you guys
want
to see some toys?
Yes.
Yeah. Wait, are these actually real toys?
Only one guy clapped. And he's got Ollie Queen's mustache. I said, do you guys want to see some toys?
Yeah. Ollie Queen, I like that.
Yeah, exactly. I don't want to break kayfabe.
No, of course not.
No.
Of course not. Okay, now tell Swiftor, ask him that same question.
Yeah,
again.
Wait. Are these actually toys I can
purchase? Of course they are. You can have. Why would I make a catalog of toys you wouldn't be able to buy? That would be crazy.
You're right. That'd be crazy. Why even ask questions?
Crazy.
You're right. Absolutely.
Silly.
Insane.
All right.
Insane.
So, I remember getting a Sears catalog, and that's how we Christmas shop.
Yes.
He'd throw us the Sears catalog, and we'd circle things for Santa Claus. That we'd want.
Yep.
And this seems like that kind of thing.
I was a huge fan of the Sears Wish Book. I would read it from October to December.
Yep.
Like, I was just so excited. Because I definitely couldn't afford toys, but I sure could look at them.
Oh, absolutely. That's the best part.
Yeah. And so this is very similar to the Sears Wish Book. So, you know, the first item up for up that you guys can buy is the Lana Del Rey gun.
Oh, hey.
It turns your voice into a smoky, depressing mess.
Wow. That sounds good. $19.95, that's a pretty good
price point. It's a bargain. It's twice the price, if you ask me.
Can you imitate it?
Yeah. Well, what you do is you shoot yourself in the throat with it.
Yeah.
Okay. And then all of a sudden you're like, da 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 na 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 na.
All right, sold. All right. Sign me up for like all five right. of these. All right,
putting
I'm
that
down.
On my list.
Look, and if you're not into, if you don't want to sound like America's tweeest zombie, you can also buy the Nerf foam electric chair. It's a fun, safe way to execute kids.
Woo! $84.95.
Well, there's a lot of foam in there.
There's got to be a lot of foam.
Yeah.
So it's all foam. There's no actual electrocution going on. My kids will be safer. Not that I have any.
Moving on to the next one.
No,
and next we got the yo-yo. It's a staple of the gangsterous rap community. I think that's how it's pronounced, right?
Gangsterous.
Yeah. Yeah, the gangsterous rap community. We're selling this for $5.95.
I like. Now, can you? Does it have to have Tupac, or can you get like? Can you get Biggie on one? Or
is
can you get
that
like
Tupac?
I think so.
I thought that was just a random stock model. Oh, okay. I don't
it
think
is
we
similarity.
Licensed Tupac.
Oh, likeness. Likeness rights. Uh-oh.
Well, hopefully see you guys at like some kind of hip skateboarding Bible. The tagline is, if you're a Christian, you could buy this.
Say, maybe you could buy this.
You can just pull in more people to the church this way, you know? Just like it's cool again, you know?
Now, hold on.
Not that it isn't cool already.
No. I need to clarify
what
something.
What could be cooler than church?
I need to clarify something. Is it a Bible on a skateboard, or is it like a skateboarder's Bible, or what is it?
It's a Bible on a skateboard for skateboarders who need Bibles.
That sounds like you're filling a lot of gaps there. You're filling a lot of need.
The Bible itself is a mini skateboard. So you get two skateboards for the price of one.
Man.
Yeah, exactly.
I love this.
Selling good toys here at Toys for Cheap.
Now, obviously, these are not like actual pictures of the items. Who drew these pictures?
Oh, well, these artist representations were drawn by a guy named Jimmy Hasse. He's the lead art director for The Onion. And it's only because we couldn't afford cameras or film. But these are real toys.
Okay, oh, but you can afford artists for pennies on the dollar.
Oh, what could be cheaper than artists? Right. I mean, you pay them pennies, you know? It's like, look, what was this guy going to be doing? Eating out of a dumpster? He's lucky.
He's an artist.
Yeah, exactly.
He should feel fortunate for this opportunity to draw these items that actually exist and can be purchased.
Yeah, And you guys should be fortunate to be talking to me right now. Hello.
I feel it.
All should feel fortunate. All right, what else do we got? We got Tickle Me Elmore Leonard. Laugh with the author of Rum Punch.
Wow.
When you tickle him, he mostly asks you to stop tickling him and then talks a lot about how Get Shorty was ruined in editing. But again, you know, if you have a very literate kid, you might want to buy Tickle Me Elmore Leonard.
Hey, it comes with a smoking cigarette, right?
I love that.
This is ready to go.
Stop tickling me. I don't like it.
Mm-hmm. What else we got? We got the Jimmy Carter in action figure who goes, I'm sorry. It's the perfect gift for someone who only knows about Carter through the lens of 80s stand-up.
Oh, my God. Whoa. I remember watching my first episodes of, like,
SNL?
No, SNL. Well, yes, SNL and the Comic Relief.
Yeah.
And stuff like that. Oh, my God. And there were definitely jokes about Jimmy Carter in there.
Yeah, a lot of Carter material. And we're bringing it back. What could be more relevant than picking on a 91-year-old man who builds houses for the poor?
Yeah, and it's a toy for children of now.
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. At least until President Trump is elected. Am I right, folks?
Oh, yeah.
Make America great again.
Yes.
You seem like a real Trump head, right? Us ethnic guys love Donald Trump.
Of course.
Can't wait for it.
Yeah, exactly. Absolutely.
Let's see what else we got. We got the train. You know that band Train? This is the train. Finally learned the meaning of the name of the band Train with the train. It's the perfect way to meet Virginia and runs on real drops of Jupiter, a.k.a. propane. Uh-huh. Be the coolest kid in your class reunion with the train.
Wow.
That I would buy that.
What's the size of it, you think? Is it like a...
Dude, Drops of Jupiter was like my record for whatever year it came out. I just listened to that thing over and over again. I love this guy. I saw him live. I actually saw Train live.
Daddy works on carburetors. Mommy's a fine mediator
for the president.
Meet Virginia. Wait, do we have the rights to this? No,
no,
are we all
we
fired?
Let's edit that out, guys.
It's in fair use. It's okay. Oh. And it's far enough away from the original that it won't get flagged, I promise you.
Exactly. The Supreme Court ruled that if you sing something badly, it's not copyrighted.
Exactly. There's no cover here.
Let's see what else we got.
Right.
John Candyland.
Oh, hey.
The game that benefited most from the death of John Belushi. And again, these are real toys.
Real toys.
I have to insist these are real toys.
Now, is it a board game?
It is a board game. You can play Mog. You can
play
Harry Crumb.
Oh, my God. Uncle Buck.
Uncle Buck or just John Candy from the set of SCTV.
I'd want to play him from Planes, Trains, and Automobiles.
That's in the expansion set, John Candy. Yeah.
Okay, we'll have to wait for that.
DLC, because we want to make you pay for a game twice.
There we go. All
right.
Hot take. What else we got? Mom's friend, Charlie.
Oh.
Mom's secret daytime friend who smells like cigarettes. Later, I called him Dad.
That's me.
Charlie!
Yay! I'm Charlie. Tell your mom I said hi.
Oh, I will.
Yeah, I'll call her. This Dad.
Stretch the Truth Armstrong, the doll that lies on its resume. Warning, does not stretch.
So the arm just comes like that, and if you try to stretch it any longer, it just like snaps off.
No, it breaks like a twig. Much like my arms. I was going to step to those Lucha Underground guys before, and they were literally going to murder. It was going to be pretty ugly, my lord. What else do we got? Guns for Girls. The sisters are killing it for themselves.
Oh, my
Who
God.
Who hasn't wanted an AK-47 with a wig and a skirt?
Why has that not been done before?
Because my company wasn't open until now. Again, Toys for Cheap. You can get the catalog at Amazon.com. Search for Toys for Cheap. And then we're not going to do that one. And finally, we have a bunch of Urkel Bull.
Oh, my God. It's been so long.
Including the Urkel pill splitter. Got any benzodiazepines? We got the Urkel tub stopper. Care for an indoor swim, my pet? Urkel Blake 1099s for freelancers. Did I deduct that? We've got German Chancellor Angela Merkel. And what's she holding? That's right. Iraq seeks uranium to power Urkelbot army. She's the one that got us into that bogus war.
Oh, my God.
The Urkel ride control baton. A nerd's got to do what a nerd's got to do. And then finally, how to lurkle with Steve Urkel. A 60-minute VHS cassette tape. That's it, my pet. Take it all off. But you can take it all on when you go to DevastatorPress.com or Amazon.com searching for Toys for Cheap. Buy my book. I'm not sure if you can tell. I'm very poor. I could really use it.
Dude, that was amazing.
Wow, dude. That was a hell of a pitch.
That's
wow.
me. That's what I do. It's dude. My company. It's my life.
I feel like you're like a... Now I'm going to blank on his name. Well,
Gordon Gekko?
The yelling infomercial guy.
Billy Mays
I'm
here.
Billy Mays here.
Yeah, only my clothes have lots of stains.
How long did it take you to find these toys to sell?
This has been a lifelong pursuit. But again, if you're looking to buy these toys, I want you to go to Amazon.com. I want you to search for Toys for Cheap. I want you to buy this catalog because unlike most catalogs, you have to purchase it for $12.
Yeah.
And when you do, Daddy gets a little money so Daddy can get some of his medicine.
There we go.
And there are a lot. I mean, this honestly, like if I were to be straight for a second, this reminds me of back in the Mad Magazine.
Thank you.
It definitely reminds me of stuff like that, like the parody and that kind of stuff. It's fantastic. It's a great book to take a dump to. Would you say it's good? It's good dump material.
It's a bathroom reader, and I'm a bathroom writer, so it works out well.
Oh, do you sit there and go like, oh my God, that's great?
People are like, get out of there! I'm like, I've got genius bits though.
it's brewing and stewing in here. It's great. I'm having the time of my life. This is just flowing out of me. I don't understand what these four walls do
I'm
to my brain.
I'm flowing from two directions here. My pen and something else. Let's move on.
Oh, man.
Well, thank you so much for showing us.
That's awesome, man.
Toys for Cheap. You can check it out on Amazon.com. Get it. It's well worth it. It's a lot of fun.
And Jonah Ray endorsed it. And everybody likes that guy. Thank you guys so much.
Thank you for showing us. Man, I had a blast. All right, don't go away. We got more stuff coming to you right here from the Twitch stage. Stick around.